Dooby doo dee da, ba dooby doo die. Hi! Thanks to my new power strip, I can do my laundry, my nails, my fur, listen to music, and
your guacamole, Ruff.
Have guacamole brought to me by a droid, all at the same time. Oh, and I can watch TV. Uh-oh, a fuel fuse. How will I host my show? Or get more guacamole? No, don't panic, Ruff. Candles, yes. Ow, ow. Ooh, that sounded expensive. Ooh. Oh, this is kind of nice. I feel like I'm in the 17th century. Oh, wait a minute. Henry, hey. Oh, did I wake you? Oh, I'm sorry. Well, listen, I got a great idea. A time machine. I'm going to send the fetchers back to the colonial days to experience life in the 17th century. Now, listen, all I need is about 200 million tops for a prototype. I'm going to... hello? Henry?
Your guacamole, Ruff.
Not now, droid. I'm thinking.
Your guacamole, Ruff.
Life was missing its mystique. My squeaky toys had lost their squeak.
And then, out of the blue, I saw the phone, and bam! My destiny was calling me. Pitched my vision for a show. They loved it. Thought I was a pro. They got my contract back to find. To their alarm, a dog had signed. Oh, I like that name. I didn't wait to renovate. Found six contestants, all were great. And now I'm on the road to fame. I've got a game show and its name is... it's very catchy. It rolls off the tongue. Wait, stop. Somebody want to tell me why we got cats singing?
Funding for Fetch with Ruff Ruffman has been provided by the National Science Foundation, where discoveries begin. The Arthur Vining Davis Foundations, dedicated to strengthening America's future through education. And by Arby's. And by Green Dog.
And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
And prithee, here cometh the contestants now. She desireth a radio scanner for her birthday, Julia. Yea, and verily, a 40 gigabyte hard drive is what he wanted, Noah. Forsooth, he has ardor for science class, Khalil. Extra cheese is most comely pizza to Taylor. He findeth the dentist malodorous, Brian. Even though she adores cats, those feline shaped incubi from the netherworld were still most fond of Anna. Let us peruse the scoring to date. In fifth place with 205 points, Taylor. Tied for fourth with 240, Brian and Noah. In third place with 295 points, Khalil. In second with an even 300 points, Julia. And in first place, the lovely Anna with 340 points. Hey, who they are? Goody contestants, and welcome to Fetch with Ruff Ruffman, the reality show where we disport ourselves for amusement and prizes. Methinks you're looking well.
What's with the music in the old English?
Yeah, what you say?
What's with the accent?
Let's get the accent.
What accent, Goody Julia?
Well, I was detecting a hint of medieval English.
No, all right, I can't do this all day. It's 17th century talk. That's not quite medieval, but 17th century.
I try.
All right, today's challenge is going to be a little different, guys. Do you see the empty box in front of you to your left?
Yeah, what is that?
And do you see the barrel to your right?
Yeah.
The box to your left is where I want you to put all your belongings that are in modern day time.
Oh, goodness.
Anything that you would not find in, 1627. That's right. Put them all in the box. My cell phone into the box. I'll return them if I can't sell them for money. So, the whiskey barrel to your right. Noah, I want you to go to the barrel and open it.
Go, Noah. Hurry up, kid.
Hurry, we know.
Let's go, Noah.
What's in it?
Oh, hat.
All right, everyone gets a 17th century outfit. Your name is on your outfit. So let's not get confused. Don't break anything.
Oh, that's a cool hat, Freddy. This one's mine. Oh, yeah.
Bless the rest of us.
Oh, the boys look so fly.
Okay, guys. Here's the deal. Today you're going to go back in time to the year 1627.
Oh my goodness.
Where? You guys are going to break up into two teams, boys versus girls.
Your first challenge will be to find Resolved White.
Resolved Anyone know White. What Resolved White is?
No idea.
You don't
is it
know?
A band?
None of you?
No.
It's not a band, but you guys are going to find out what it is. So, Noah, Taylor, Khalil, Julia, Brian, and Anna, I'm going to miss you guys.
I'm going to miss you too, Ruff.
All the details are in the mailbox. Now go fetch.
Hey, that Brian.
Let's go.
It's my cell phone.
Well, as you know, I asked Henry for a time machine that would have sent these kids back no problem, but I was turned down. I had no other choice but to rework some of the wiring in the Fetch 3000 to create my own time machine. Let's hope it works, otherwise we have no show. All right, 3, 2, 1. Well, here we are, 1627. It's not very fancy. These houses are shabby. Not a lot of street signs either. Gee, as a matter of fact, there's not much traffic at all. Look at the clothing these people are wearing. Wouldn't catch J-Lo in one of these. I hope this was a good idea. Now the kids are looking for Resolved White.
What is Resolved White anyway?
You want to know what Resolved White is?
Yeah.
Go back in the garden over here and ask Priscilla
okay.
Olde.
Do you know what Resolved White is?
Perhaps you should look over there.
What is Resolved White?
Do you know what Resolved White is?
Resolved White.
Resolved White.
Yeah. Resolved White is a boy.
A boy?
Oh, that's pretty good. Listen,
if you ask good wife Gobberson to that garden there, she may come.
I think the best person at Plymouth Plantation to ask is probably Mistress Winslow.
Thank you.
Mistress Winslow.
Do you know where Resolved White is?
Indeed I do. Resolved White is my son.
Well, there you go. Resolved White. That's Mistress Winslow's son.
Oh, and I dare say if you look about a bit, you'll find him.
You guys, listen. Resolved? Are you looking for me?
We're looking for you.
Boys win, they find Resolved White first. All right, 1627, let's get some challenges. I'll just give one of them a call on their phone, and I... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I took all their phones. Oh, man! How am I supposed to give out challenges if I can't call them? Oh, Ruff, use your brain!
I heard you're gonna hit me with some work today.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. What's Resolved White doing?
The first thing I have to do today is grind some corn.
Let's go, boys.
Oh, that's perfect. That's the first challenge. We'll have a corn grinding contest. Good thinking, Ruff.
Do you know why I need flour?
To make bread?
Yes, all right. All we'll ready? See who is going to make the most flour in order to make bread. Corn first has to come off the ear. Good. And then the corn goes into the mortar. And
a mortar and pestle? Well, I guess they didn't have blenders back then. I just grind it with my teeth.
If I hadn't known this was corn, I would have thought this was Resolved White. I had no idea.
Another step we have to do is to sift it. These cloths are called bolting cloths. Put it in the cloth, and then you sift it through. You children each will take a mortar and pestle. You'll have to pound corn, bring it over to your trough, and bolt it.
Okay.
This is very exciting. Oh,
is there something I'm doing wrong here?
See how there's hole pieces?
Yeah.
You want to grind it up so it's very small. See how she has it?
Yeah.
Hold me.
Take. That was hard.
Seems like a lot of work just to grind some corn.
Oh my goodness, they have so much more flour than we do.
Oh no.
This thing, she's killing me.
My hands are on fire, Ruff.
Oh, let's see who won.
Is this yours? Let's see what you got.
Come on, that's not flour.
That's yours?
I don't know. What do you think?
I have to say, I want to eat bread made
bread
of this.
Yet. I think the girls.
I don't want to eat bread made of
this. No, the girls win.
I don't either.
Girls, take the second challenge.
What a curious custom.
You want to try it?
There you go. Yeah, it's a little colonial high five for you. How am I going to dish out challenges if I don't have any technology to use? Now, wait a minute. I have technology. I have the Fetch 3000. I converted it into a time machine. If I can send six kids, I can send a note. All right. Fetch 3,000. I need a 1627 Colonial font. Excellent. Now to send these kids a note. I'll send it to Uncle Winslow. If I get the coordinates right, he should be able to receive it quite easily.
Well, I just received this letter. I don't know who it's from.
Hey, guys. So these are the cabins you'll be spending the night in. As you can clearly see, one is luxurious and fabulous. The other is basically empty. The winners of the next challenge will score themselves the finished cabin. Oh, awesome! The second place team will have extra work to do. They'll need to clean up the cabin and make places to sleep on. Good luck from Ruff.
I know just the competition that I need some help with as well. Now, around the back of the house, we have some gardens here, but they're getting pretty well dry, so I think they need some watering. In each of these, we have there is an equal amount of water. When you put this in the water, it comes up through here as the air is coming out the top. When you take this out, if you have your thumb over it, it keeps the water from coming out.
And when you let go?
And when you let go, it does come out, so the air is coming in.
Well, I just use a hose.
I'll let the girls on that one and the boys on this one.
Okay.
After the time is done, whoever has the lowest amount of water in their kettles will win. Ready? Set? Go!
All right, so the challenge is on. They have to water the garden now with these small jugs.
She needs a top.
You're doing it wrong. You just need to hold it upside down.
Run, Noah, run.
Run, 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 run.
Okay. Oh, that doesn't look like he's doing it right.
Come on, Noah, come on.
Who has the life rod?
Go, 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 go. Get a little water.
That's the right way to do it, so it looks like it's coming out like a shower.
Oh, goodness. Kind of fun, Ruff. You're missing out on it.
That's fine by me. I like my technology.
If your watering pot has 20 ewls in the bottom
and
one in the top, which way do you think you're going to get more water to come out of it?
All right, we're done!
Let's see who wins.
Now, let's look at the boys' bucket. Quite a bit of water left. And now the girls.
I think it's pretty clear that the girls won this one.
Well, that's two in a row for the ladies.
So you'll be sleeping in the finished house.
Yes, yes. Come on.
And the boys in the unfinished house.
In the unfinished house, you better start getting comfortable to the ground.
You okay, guys?
Better start like...
Well, the lads, they've got to make their bed. But you will help me prepare our supper.
What's cooking?
Well, come, I will show you.
I think we best be making our beds. With this sack here, I'm going to fill it with this straw.
Okay.
When that's all well filled, we're just going to sew it shut.
Oh, they got to make the beds?
Chicken turkey.
You remember when I was rather teasing the lads and said, well, I don't know as I want to eat bread out of what you pounded here. I have to say, I don't want to eat bread made of that.
The girls wait.
Actually, what they did pound is something that you can cook with, and we're going to put this in the broth. Now, if someone wants to begin plucking that turkey from the bones,
I can do that.
Don't be mindful. It smells really good.
First time you ever make a bed?
Well, I've made my bed before, but I haven't made my bed.
If you think you're going to sleep on that, it's not nearly full enough.
Put your feet in there. Get inside. Get your whole body inside.
Do you think this is enough?
I'd say you have most of it.
If we were at home right now, we'd be starting up the microwave with the oven.
What is that for?
It's kind of like a cabinet that, like, you press a button and then it gets really hot inside the cabinet. And it's really
so you do not have a hearth like this, and you do not burn wood.
Well, we do, but we don't cook on it.
Do you know how to thread a needle? That's probably the best way to do it. It doesn't need to be pretty. It just needs to be slept on. You just keep going around, yeah? I think it's going pretty well.
I'm having a really tough time with this.
It doesn't matter, Brian. You're wearing a cool hat.
I'm going to get the pot and we can cast this turkey into it.
So it's going to be more like a soup. Almost like a stew. Hey, Ruff, this dinner looks pretty good.
Yes, it does.
Sad you're missing out on it.
I am. Bring me some.
Raised with turkey stew, though. It's turkey pottage.
We'll save some for you, Ruff.
Not cat, unfortunately.
Hey, I don't eat cat. I just dislike them. You don't eat anybody you have a disagreement with, do you?
Perfect. We're just about done anyhow.
It's actually not a bad-looking mattress.
Yeah, try it out.
I'm going to try out my bed for tonight.
Flatten it very
comfy.
I'd take a mattress any day.
Oh, good stuff.
Good night, Ruff.
it's dinner.
Serve yourself out, son.
Can you please pass the mustard?
And the girls did all the cooking.
Why do I keep doing shows with food in it? This is torture.
Are the girls good cooks?
I like the mussels.
I'm gonna order some Chinese. I can, because I have all the phones.
This tastes exactly like what we eat after Thanksgiving is over.
I don't understand. Isn't Thanksgiving a day in church? And then you eat turkey after that?
It's just a special day where we give thanks.
I think you are speaking of the very first year that we were here.
Yes.
We brought in a very good harvest. All right. Yep. Let us be on our way.
Hey, after I eat a big meal, I am out. Can't do nothing. Ready for bedtime. Oh, good. They get to go to bed, too.
Whew, I am beat.
What a nice house.
No, compared to the boys sleeping on the floor.
The floor and a straw bag.
Guys, this is our cabin for the night.
Yep.
You guys think we should move this candle over?
No, we should sleep on against the wall.
Well, I'll move this over a little bit.
So many buttons on these things.
I know.
The skirts are especially hard to unbutton.
Somebody undo my apron.
Man, just try to get our dress.
It takes me at home like 20 seconds.
I know.
Takes me no time at all. I never wear clothes. Maybe a collar. Depends if I'm going out.
I don't like my bed a lot better than this.
Ruff, you did good, but, you know, nothing can compare to our beds.
Yeah. Hey, is it bad?
So how do we brush our teeth here?
Cloth?
I think I'm just going to skip.
I think I'll pass for tonight.
Hey, look, you guys. The chamber pot's ready.
Just wait.
Are you kidding me, Ruff?
Seriously. Julia.
Better than a fire hydrant.
Disgusting. Yes, we.
That looks fine to me. I gotta go on a tree.
Hold on, so where are you sleeping, Noah?
I called the middle first.
Come on, I wanted the middle so I could look up at the sky.
I called the middle.
Good gosh, this is really comfy.
Is it?
Peace out, Ruff.
Yes, peace out.
Good night, Ruff.
Good night, John boy.
Yeah, talk to you in the morning. We'll see you tomorrow, Ruff.
Bye. Good night, guys. I will see you first thing in the morning, my little colonial challengers. Oh, excuse me, was that me?
God, Mordold, you have been abed quite late. I pray you favor raspberries.
Love raspberries.
Ooh, raspberries.
This reminds me of cereal, doesn't it?
Yeah. All right, the Fetch 3000 time machine is locked on the coordinates of the breakfast table. And now to send their challenge. Let's see. Oh, some cows. Oh, goats. Okay, excellent. Into the Fetch 3000. Lock on coordinates and launch! Yeah, right on the table. I'm 3 for 3.
Look at that, guys. I think it's a note.
Oh, so rough.
Hope you all had a good night's sleep. Today, you guys get to choose your chore for the morning. You have your choice between cows and goats. Have some breakfast and then head over to the field.
Milking cows is really
fun. If we're
fun.
Milk, just do cows. Yeah, just as, you know,
we'll take the goats.
So let's see who has to do what, shall we? Somebody's gonna be mad at Ruff.
Ew.
I have a feeling there's cow doo-doo out here.
Yep.
Go! Enjoy, girls! Scoop away!
If you find a turd, you pick it up.
And then... Oh, it smells so bad.
Here's the basket.
Let's get to our
goat basket.
Oh, gosh.
So, I understand you boys chose goats.
We're gonna milk them? Oh, nice!
Grab your turd and let's get started.
Turd, you say?
I wouldn't normally be doing this in a skirt.
I wouldn't normally be doing this at all.
What are you gonna use with this, all this cow dung?
Well, we use it for fertilizer in the gardens. Excuse me, Julie, I don't want to get this poop on you.
I'm stepping in lots of poopy.
I cannot believe that 4 cows produce this much poop.
Well, let's get this started. Oh. All right, who wants to try?
I'll try.
Claws.
Try that one, yeah. Come on. All right, let someone else try.
It was a fresh one.
Hey, Ruff, we only do this for cows, not dogs. So I don't even ask.
Do I ever ask? I don't even feel comfortable discussing that type of business.
Can you get it?
What does it feel like?
Squeeze at the top. Can you feel the milk in there sort of moving up and down?
No, is it gross?
No.
Her eyes go crazy.
It's not coming out, though.
No, she's not going to come.
I think I got some milk on my finger, though.
I think you boys are just not meant to be milkmaids, which...
That's kind of good because we're not maids.
Yeah, I noticed. But you did give it a valiant try.
Let's take a peek over there, see what they're doing. Oh, they're milking them. That's not fair.
Well, girls, you chose the cows.
Not fair.
Pick your daughter.
Okay. Can I push it back?
Oh!
What?
There was poop on it. It's on my finger.
Well, you're gonna have to wash it.
Ew, Julia, get Dina some soap.
All right, Ruffster, final challenge. This will be the best one yet. Now all I need to do is place this letter into the pocket of Mistress Winslow. Lock on coordinates, fetch 3,000, and launch! Yes!
One of you know how to read?
I do.
You do?
Yeah, I can read.
Yeah. Well then, here.
Hold on. Thanks. Nice work. Grab the other team and head back to your final competition. The first team to saw through their log first and haul the wood to the store wins the largest points yet. This is the great finale of all the Colonial challenges.
I'm still gonna win.
Ruff. We have to win this one.
All right, guys, let's go get the girls.
Let's go.
All right, everyone, let's go in here. Now, it's the girls over here and the boys over here, but before we start...
Well, that's a lot more work than using a chainsaw. Look at the size of that thing.
Oh, be careful, kids.
You're each going to just cut off one piece. And that one piece, we're going to bring over to these wheelbarrows. And there's some wood aside each one. You're going to put that on the wheelbarrow, go out the gate, down the lane, to the oven.
So whoever gets to the oven first, all their wood wins.
And are you
with all their wood wins.
This
are
thing.
You ready? Well, let's get some firewood. Go.
And they're off.
Oh, no, don't pull something. Keep going, guys.
The girls don't seem to be making too big of a dent here. And the boys have their piece sawed off first. The girls are still lagging behind. Now the boys are stacking the wood in the wheelbarrow. The competition is stiff. This is going to be an Olympic event, I can feel it.
No, make sure it stays. Go. All right. Almost
there, guys. All right.
Okay, there we go.
There's a piece. The boys are heading down the lane. The girls are starting to stack the wood. Who knew 1627 could be so exciting? And the boys have reached the oven. And the girls are casually strolling down the lane. Now the girls know they've been beaten, but they still make it all the way to the end and unload their wood.
Yes, you got second!
Woo! I understand you will soon be leaving again.
Yeah, they're leaving as soon as I finish the chapter on sending the kids back through the time machine.
Okay, all right. Whew. What an adventure.
See you guys.
All right, Fetch 3000, let's bring our fetchers home. In 3, 2... Where are my kids? This is not good. So how's it going? Welcome to Fetch with Ruff Ruffman. I'm looking for 6 new contestants. Oh, never mind, here they are. Of course, I knew what I was doing.
Welcome back, fetchers, to the 21st century!
I'm smiling, trying to get back here.
Oh, man.
So what'd you guys think about going back in time?
That was really cool.
So what do you guys think? Was sawing a log reward enough, or should we give out some points?
Points!
Yeah. Give us points!
Points it is! It turns out Resolvent White isn't the name of a house paint. No, he was a boy and your guide.
Are you looking for me?
For finding him, Khalil, Noah, and Brian, 50 points.
Fancy. Oh, good stuff.
When a tedious job is called a grind, now you know why.
That was hard.
For winning the corn mash relay, 50 points to the girls.
Yeah. You guys invite...
Well, boys, hope this challenge didn't get your goat. For getting milk out of Tessel, 25 points.
Yes. Good job, guys.
Now, girls, not everybody's going to love this, but it makes for some good TV.
Excuse me, Julie, I don't want to get this poop on you.
Shoveling cow doo-doo. Yay.
For pitching cow dung with style, 50 points.
Fun.
Well, let's get some firewood.
Now, the grand finale, the log-off. 50 points at stake, and the boys take it.
Good job, guys.
What time is it?
Bonus points!
Oh!
Julia.
There was poop on it. It's on my finger.
Hunger.
For putting on a brave face in the face of poo.
5 points.
Hey!
And Anna.
Yeah?
For good sportsmanship and teamwork in the face of defeat.
Yes, that's second.
An extra 10 points.
Which means the daily winner is... There's a three-way tie! Brian, Khalil, Noah!
Yes.
Congratulations on your epic win! Being the daily winner means an unforgettable prize, but is the unforgettable prize something you'd rather forget? Your choice, gentlemen. What will you do?
I'd take it.
I think we should take it.
Just take the prize.
Take it! Now, gentlemen, reach into your mailbox.
Let's go.
Oh.
Through the Fetch 3000 time machine, I have transported your dirty socks. If you look over to your right.
You guys are washing socks!
Start washing some socks. While these boys scrub their dirty socks, we're gonna take off. So until next time, I'm Ruff Ruffman. See ya! See that? I could even go back in time and have a great show. Now, to be fair to the kids, I've decided to go 17th century style for the rest of the day. Ooh, I can't wait to tuck into my yummy turkey pottage. Oh. And my cucumber, apparently. Hunan Palace? Yeah, hi. It's Ruff, yep. I got a big order for you this time. Okay, one last thing. Not only do I host my own television show, but I have a fantastic website, too. Check it out! There are tons of great games and lots more. It's like winning a staring contest with a cat. PBSKidsGo.org. Funding for Fetch with Ruff Ruffman has been provided by the National Science Foundation, where discoveries begin. The Arthur Vining Davis Foundations, dedicated to strengthening America's future through education. And by Arby's. And by Green Dog. And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.